So, under the car this week, I took a week off on vacation to do some family things and tech a little bit on this machine. So everything's been working really well, except I found a little bit of a issue that I think is a result of my exhaust design. So the way that it currently works, both the left bank and the right bank from the engine come together and merge relatively quickly underneath the car here. It's a relatively abrupt merge, but it does use mandrel bends and almost runs tangent to each other. It's hard to see here. Anywho, that's part of what I'm thinking is going on, and I'll explain it in a bit. The other one is moving along here. This is just a center resonator to try to absorb some raspiness that I think it does a great job at. But I've got my secondary O2 sensors measuring after this guy. And I think the core of the issue is that these guys are now looking at exhaust gas from both banks after it's merged. And what I wasn't aware of until recently, reading the function Raman from Bosch on the MED9.1 system, is that these secondary wide bands, number one, I thought they were narrow bands, but they actually are wide band sensors. So that's something I learned recently. The other one is that the ECM control logic for long-term fuel trim looks at the post-CAT O2 sensors, which I also thought it was just the pre-CAT O2 sensors, which are hiding up there. Those, of course, are wide bands. So what I've been seeing is that under some light load conditions, I do get an imbalance left to right bank of the long-term fuel trim, but really just the long-term fuel trim, not an issue on the short-term fuel trims. So I think it's, again, because both sensors are reading from the merged exhaust gas. So between this merge here, that probably could be a bit better, a bit more soft, which also, in theory, could be leaning or contributing to maybe some left to right bank volumetric efficiency differences at certain conditions, and the O2 sensor placement, I will be running rebuilding the charge plumbing here using some oval aluminum tubing to kind of narrow this up a bit. And then right next to it, I'll run some stainless oval tubing, which I'll show you guys here in a second. So I'll keep the left and right bank divided, separate, past this transmission support. And it will come together very gradually about right here. So the merge will come together a bit later in the system. The sensors will get divorced again, so both the primary and secondary O2 sensors will be measuring truly just left bank and right bank exhaust gases. So hopefully improved merge and improved oxygen sensor placement. And also in doing so, this charge pipe will likely end up, well, I'm going to try to, instead of making it have essentially one, two bends to get to the oval flat section there, it will be a slightly bit more of an angle and just have a single bend, which will have to be pie cuts to make it to this angle here. So very, very subtle difference, but ultimately I think it will look better and maybe work a bit better. So here's the oval stuff. This oval is from CX Racing. It's considered their 2.5-inch oval. Really nicely formed stuff. In the past, I've used oval stainless from Spintech, which is, this is the oval stuff from Spintech. So it worked well. It's also oval. But as you can see, the cross-section of the Spintech, let's do side by side. Those are both considered 2.5-inch ovals, so SpinTech here, CX Racing here. This is much nicer for packaging. I think they both will flow just fine for what I need. So I've got a 45 bend. This will be the majority of the downpipe. So I have this round transition. Of course, this will all get shortened up. So it'll attach to the stock header here. I'll have the first O2 sensor probably somewhere here. That'll be the factory wideband. Merge or transition down to the oval for the bend. This will go underneath the transmission support. And then I bought this mandrel bend oval to be able to kind of wiggle around if I need to. But this will essentially flow back. It'll merge back to 2.5 inch round. And then I'll create the 2.5 inch merge. On the left side, I've got just some nice, a nice 45 here. This is from JMD Tubing. They always produce really, really good stuff. Very few tooling marks. Nice stainless. So I'll be remaking the left downpipe as well. And then, of course, all that will be merging, as I said, later. Including a few more flex couplings, just to freshen everything up. And then here's the oval aluminum. So 065 wall. These are the two transitions. Not real fancy parts. These are from Stainless Headers, I believe is the name of the company. So there's I may have misspoke before, but this is their 3-inch oval. So it's equivalent to a 3-inch round. So that oval section will run the majority of the length. And like I said, I'll probably chop this a bit to make a few pie cuts to make that subtle bend I was mentioning earlier. And then, of course, the transitions on either end to go back to the 3-inch on either side. So I'll be playing with that the next few days. Hopefully tomorrow I can get it all wrapped up and we'll see how it does. But shouldn't be a big performance change, just making the ECM control things a bit more predictably and maybe make that transition a bit better. So, yep, that's it.